He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave Explains.
Hey guys, for today's problem, what we're going to want to do is, this molecule is called acetamide, and acetamide is a weak base, so it can react with a strong acid. So if it reacts with hydrochloric acid, which is a strong acid, we want to draw what is going to result. We want to draw the conjugate acid of this weak base. So if this seems confusing, you're going to want to go back to my general chemistry series and take a look at acids and bases, specifically Bronsted-Lowry acids and bases, and see how those work and see if you can draw the correct product of this acid-base reaction. Okay guys, so we remember that Bronsted-Lowry acids and bases, when these kinds of reactions happen, this is about proton transfer. And so we said that acetamide is a weak base, so if it acts as a Bronsted-Lowry base, it's going to be a proton acceptor, and of course hydrochloric acid being a strong acid is a proton donor. So the question is, where does the proton go on the molecule? Because a proton acceptor is typically something like a lone pair. But there are two atoms on the molecule that have lone pairs. We have this carbonyl oxygen has two lone pairs, as well as the nitrogen in the amino group has a lone pair. And so where is it going to go? The question, the way that we answer that question is we have to look at the resulting conjugate acids. So let's say, first of all, that the lone pair on the nitrogen goes ahead and grabs that proton. Now, this is what would result. So we would have a formal positive charge on the nitrogen atom, okay? And now look at the other option. We have these two lone pairs on the carbonyl oxygen. Let's say one of those grabs a proton. This is what would result, and then the key feature that we want to understand about this is that this structure is resonance stabilized, okay, because we can see that, so we have a formal positive charge on the oxygen, which is unfavorable. However, the lone pair from the nitrogen atom can go right here, kick this pi bond up there, and then this is the other resonance structure. And so what that means is that the composite resonance structure is actually going to look like this, where we have a delocalized positive charge, right, all along that portion of the molecule. Now we know that formal charges are resonance stabilized. If they are resonance stabilized, that's more stable. They are at a lower energy, and so this is a more stable structure, and so that is why hydrochloric acid will protonate this molecule at the carbonyl position. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.